What's up, guys? Welcome back to Coffee Doodles in Quarantine. So today I'm going to do some digital drawing. I've got my cup of coffee with me, and we're just going to do episode 4. I'm really excited. Getting a really good response to this, and I'm having a lot of fun, so we're going to keep this rolling. I'm on day 15 in quarantine. Only gone outside once to go for a little car ride. Nothing too wild, but other than that, we've just been in the house hanging out, making these videos for you guys. And I think I'm going to do a little character drawing today for you. And I'm really excited. All right, see you in a minute. Let's get to the drawing. Let's have some fun. All right, we're back. We're going to start drawing. I've got a 14 by 14, but I decided I'm actually going to extend it a little bit. I've got the animator pencil, drawing box of Kyle Webster's, and we're going to do a little sketching. Just gonna do a little, warming up. Kinda figuring it out. Playing with big shapes like I do. If you've been watching my videos, this is nothing new. It's probably pretty similar. I'm just kinda laying down. Bigger shapes. Just gestures. Marks, big marks. Moving around. And pushing back. Always pushing back and bringing forward again. That's the game. And then as you push back, refine information, go from like big brush to smallest brush, go from a broom to a toothpick. It's a good way to think about it. I might just draw all three of these, if you guys want to stick around for that. We'll see. We'll see how long I can focus for. Putting in like the suggestion of facial expression. But still, the main focus here is big shapes. Don't overthink it. Just kind of keep keep the gesture loose. Work from the elbow, you know? Don't be noodling yet. So, like, use your whole arm, use your shoulder to get those big sweeping marks. Consider a little bit about value structure. Like, all right, that part is darker, that's lighter, that's gonna have denser detail, it's gonna have less dense detail. And you can kind of like scribble in those. You don't need to refine yet. Wait to refine. Refining can come in the final inking. Now is the, you know, the point where you're just sort of figuring out the abstract. I'm gonna write that down. When I change layers, I'll write down the stages. The abstract. Yeah. And we're still thinking about, like even in like the compositions that we were doing for the other day's video, we're still thinking about like the shape language that we're using, you know, and how that can repeat through a design, because that's what good design's all about, is pattern, consistency. Design, shape design. And like, I'm still scribbling, like I'm just scribbling in, because this is going to be pushed back again. I'm thinking just a little bit about the value, mostly just the shape design. Working big, long gestures. Not stressing too much about it. And we push back again. And I'm using a big soft brush for the eraser. I believe it is the paint. The control paint, big soft brush that they have in the Basic 3 set. If you're not familiar with control paint, they're a great resource for learning how to draw and paint and digital techniques. I'm gonna switch over now to Let's do mechanical pencil. And now this is not the abstract. This is now basic penciling. So now we're gonna start sort of figuring out the details a little bit more. What's actually happening here. But still, not too tight. Keep it looser. Start figuring out what these shapes are doing. Some of those areas of detail that you had blocked in before, start deciding what's going on there. But keep it loose. You don't want to lose the flow of it too quickly. Keeping it loose, but still starting to make these decisions about what's going on. And pulling some order from this sort of chaos that you built. Thinking a little bit more about value, detail, density. Not too much about anatomy at this point. And at this phase, anything can be changed. You don't have to make any final decisions yet. Really just scribble it in. Still working from the elbow and the shoulder, keeping it loose. Switch pencils again to the pencil 4H. This is just a personal preference. You could do this all in like one brush. The brush doesn't matter. This is just my personal. I like to differentiate between the layers with different pencils and different marks. So let's get back in this Now, with this pass, we're going to be a little bit more tight. This is almost like an inking pass, but it's still with brushes. With not brushes, with pencils. Now we're gonna make some serious decisions about facial design. Anatomy. And start nail this guy down. Of course, all the information is already there. It's just a matter of making those choices. Triangle shadows, like always. Weird, like, shoulder things. Keeping it loose. Always keep it loose until the last minute. Alright, we're moving on to the next character. Start making these decisions about what their shapes are. Figuring out anatomy. And I think, you know, as you do this, I always, you know, think about story. I always get caught up while I'm drawing about, like, thinking, like, alright, who is this guy? What's his narrative? They seem to be sort of adventurers of some kind, fantasy. think in retrospect, I probably wouldn't have drawn them so close together. Hairlines. Short sword or something. Two characters lightly sketched in. I'm thinking like maybe some sort of like royal guard. Yeah, something like that. Defending. Going overboard with that straw. Alright. On to the lady. She'd have like a longer nose. She's more elven. Different species of sorts from the other two. Drying in hair is, for me, it's just about, you know, the basic shape, and creating like the wisp and the form. I've never really been interested in drawing realistic hair. Because, you know, there's people who can draw realistic hair. Not me. Some people can. It's all right. I don't think you should feel ashamed for being able to do something different from other people. You know, it's like a camera can take a photorealistic image, so we don't need to do that. It's cool, it's a neat trick, but I think it says more if you're able to express emotion through other means, through mark making that only can happen through your hand, and not replicating techniques or procedures of a camera. Like, why draw? The reason you draw and create art is because there's emotions that can be expressed only through image and art and drawing that a camera can't capture. And it's through gesture, marks, paint, all that jazz. So, you know, forget about photorealism. Because you're not going to get it on this channel. There's a lot of other channels that can do that. Alright, we've got three characters, roughly sketched. We're going to do another pass here in a minute. So we're going to push this back. I think we're going to remove that. And then we'll turn this one way down. And this one down. Okay, now we're going to do a ink pass. I'm going to pull out the, let's see what we got. So I'm going to close that. And we're in the ink box, Kyle's ink box. Now, I'm going to do a pass with the ballpoint pen KTW because it's a little bit closer to a micron than the comics inker. And it might give me a little bit different of an effect. I always use smoothing when I ink, just because it gives me a little bit of more consistent product. So this is going to be the first pass of inking, and I'll probably do multiple passes. Let's see how it goes. I want to do this in blue. A little color in the line work is sometimes a nice thing, depending on how it's done. If you get the right one, it can't be too distracting, you know. For a while, I was doing these really bright blue line work drawings, like full saturation blue. It was kind of an interesting effect. I might revisit that eventually. But it's got to be done correctly. Again, I'm always starting from a similar point. Point on the face. I don't know, I just like starting with faces. It's the part you're drawn to. It's the part that has the most emotion. So we'll just do that. Little triangle shadows, big old ears. Not that big of an ear. I feel like this guy's name would be like Wirt or something. He's like the Spitfire youngster who wants to prove himself. Searching for these places where you can block in shadow. It's always good to back off sometimes. You can kind of see how this is gonna, it's gonna go. Keeping it loose. Sorry, as I as I ink, I get a little bit more quiet. Draw that sword, I've decided. All right, on to the next character. I'm doing each character phase by phase. You know, I'm not finishing out one and moving on to the next. I'm going sort of like a factory, you know, like line work, sketch, block in for each one. Going down like an assembly line. Thinking about this, he's more of like a brutish character, brutish. Maybe not the smartest, but maybe he's like a tank type kind of guy. More strength than intelligence. He's not so sharp, so he has more round shapes.
Only you can see me.
But he does his best. I like these chops. Big old chops. I've not really drawn a character with big old chops before. Mutton chops? No, that's not what it is. Always good to back off and see how they are working together. Characters. Yeah. Take a quick break, and I'll be right back. All right, let's get back to it. I love knee pad. Little feet. It's always okay to redraw a line that you're not feeling good about. Be here. there's the first inking pass. Cool. And then from here, we are going to lower the opacity one more time, and we'll do do another one. Let's go back to the American inkers, the comic inker this time. Smoothing. Let's do it one more time. And now we're gonna really focus in here and nail the detail. Since we've drawn it so many times, we'll have no problem getting it right. There's something really satisfying about like laying down a good line after doing so many sketchy lines, you know. You like search for the line. And then when you get it, you're like, yep, that's the line. That is the line. It just feels right. I think it's, you know, be interpretive, like experiment with your marks, you know, do like little weird things that you've not tried before, have fun, remember, always have fun, having fun is the most important part. Yeah, we're getting there. I'm gonna hop around a little bit. Keep it interesting. Cool.
Thank you.
Alright. This video is getting kind of long. I think I'm going to stop it right now. And maybe I'll do a part two. Continue with this in another video. But yeah, I just don't want it to get too long. Alright guys, thank you so much for tuning in. Alright, thank you so much guys for tuning in. It's been a fun one, doing a little character sketching. I hope you guys learned a little bit about what I think when I draw characters and stuff. I probably should do a part two to this. We'll see. Obviously, I didn't finish it, but I just didn't want it to get too long. I had a good time. I had fun. If you guys have any recommendations, suggestions, let me know in the comments below what you want to see, what you're curious about, what you want to do. So keep up the views, and I'll keep up the content, and we'll go from there. Share this with your friends. Give it a like. Give it a watch. Cool. All right, thanks so much guys. Have a great day. Bye-bye.